Hi, my name is Vishal. In this video, I'll show you how to set up light for interior using Arnold in Maya software. So I have downloaded a file from internet. I'll be giving the link in the description. You can download from, and then I'll be using the ACS workflow. I've made a video on how to set up an ACS workflow, so you can check above in this card. And let's get started. So firstly, I'll just show you how to do a setup for the ACS. Go to the settings and preferences here, and in the color management you have the OCIO config path. Browse that from the right location where you have put that, and then enable this use OCIO configuration. So it will be using that ACS workflow here. It takes a while. Yeah, it has set up. Now just save it. So you got sRGB ACS here. So let's open the file here. So the file which I have got with me is in OBJ format. So let's copy that link and then import that into Maya. So file, and then choose import. So I've got this file. It looks the scene is in the real scale, because I could see the grid looks so small before the whole scene. That's good for me. I'll go to the lighting and then say two-sided lighting, because there are some normal issues with the model. I select everything and then assign AI standard surface shader. So I've pressed Shift T for that, and then use AI standard surface shader. And then I'll go to the attribute editor. I will not use any specular weight there. Now I just go to the modeling section here, and then separate the file, the model which was in pieces. So I'll just open the outliner here, and then it is in a group. I select everything and press Alt Shift D to delete the history, and then ungroup this whole thing. Now just select all the blinds here. And combine them and delete history. Combine them, delete history. So I'm doing this for the sake, because you'll be downloading the same file and you'll get this problem here. Okay, so I select these two blinds and assign AI standard surface shader. And let's name this to blind shader. So my idea is to, in Arnold, we can do the interior lighting day with different approaches. This approach, I'll be showing the physical skylight here. So we have the physical skylight, and I'm taking that physical skylight there. And I get the light outside, and then I'll create a new camera. And then set the focal length to maybe 28. I select the camera and then lock it. I'm just naming this render01 cameras. I just, if I've got multiple views, I can give 02, 03 and so on. And then get a different sequence renders there. Okay. Now what I will do is I will open the Arnold render view and then render the scene. I should see I'm getting some lighting here in this room, and the direction of the light is from this side. So I select the physical skylight there. Open attribute editor and then increase the exposure value to maybe 1. And then what I will do is I will change the elevation to 15 degrees so they get long. And then let me try 180 degrees. Then I'm getting the light here. Then I change the elevation back to 60 degrees so that I get light. 45 should be okay. So I got the light here. So the light is too dark. Whenever you're using physical skylight, I would recommend you to create additional 2 lights here. So here we got the windows. So firstly, select the window here. Select the shader of the blinds and then remove the base and specularity. Go to the subsurface and then increase the subsurface value. And then in the shape node, switch off the opaque here. So what if I don't do that? I'll show you that first. So I got this render. So I switch off the opaque, so it becomes a thin object. I'll show you additionally this feature in the artificial lights here. You'll understand why that opaque has been switched off. Okay, I was just expecting a major part of the scene gets the direct light. I'm just seeing that. So I've just placed the light accordingly. So I was talking about putting a couple of lights there. Whenever you are using the physical skylight from the windows, you put a light called portal light. Okay, but portal light has nothing in it as far as the controls are concerned. We need to just place it in the window. So you are trying to make the physical light focusing from the window. So it just cut down the render time a lot. And also it will help us to lit the room with the direct light source, which is again good for noise and so I'll just render it again. Before that, I'll just take the physical skylight here. Okay. Okay, I'll set the exposure value to 2 so that I get a little bit more lighting. The scene looks pretty dark here. So what I will do is I will go to the render settings, and we have this nice option here called diffuse ray depth. So I'll put that value to 3. Now what that actually does is it will add more indirect lighting for the scene here. The overall scene looks dark here. So I will select the I'm just worried whether this is showing up the raw image or the sRGB image. It's showing sRGB. Sometimes if you have put to the raw, it looks pretty more dark. So make sure that it is in sRGB space. It will show up a bright light there. And also let me select the shader and check with the attributes here. Yeah, it has got a white and a diffuse value of 0.8. That should look okay. I select the camera and I just go to the Arnold section here, and we have something called exposure, and we can increase the exposure to crank up the overall brightness of the room. So on the organic side, this is what the overall scene is looking like for me. It looks pretty dark. Now this is where you need to, you know, if you're what do you say, artistic direction, or if your requirement of this room to be a little bit more brighter, then I would rather prefer to keep a light from this side and create a fake fill light. So I'll just use a Maya's point light here. So I've put the point light here, and I'll put an exposure of 15. It's too much. I'll put a exposure of 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And that should be okay. And I use a color temperature and then just put some 8000 or 9000 close. So that should give a blue tint there. So I've just added a fill light, which is basically filling up the dark regions of the scene there. As there are no too much of entry points for the light, there are just two windows and maximum light can happen from this. So that's the reason why this room is looking pretty dark. So there is a physical skylight with the sun. We have two portal lights and we have a point light here. The scene is looking pretty dark for me so far. So let's try to increase the exposure of this light here. To exclusively control the sun's brightness, I'll reduce the sunlight here. The sunlight's contribution, just keeping it low. And also I'll just go to the diffuse depth here. for it generally gives the indirect lighting rays multiplication. Generally, how many times the light should bounce is what this diffuse ray depth does. Much needed attribute for this. A 3 should be generally sufficient. And I'm getting noise here, so I need to check with the lights here. So I'll put the samples to 3 for this light. And portal light, we don't have anything. And in point light, I'll put the samples to 3. And we need to check what is the reason behind the noise, because we have the samples for camera anti-aliasing. We have the samples for diffuse. We have samples for specularity. So majorly in this particular scene, I've not used reflections or glass materials. So I need to work with the camera anti-aliasing and the diffuse samples here. And that should be more than sufficient for my noise fixing. Somehow I have, I don't have a good impression on the render time for the interiors in Arnold, because I've seen it takes hours together to render the interior. I'll just put the render and then get back on how much time does this overall render takes. So if you see, I'm just going for the normal render here, whose size is 960 by 540 pixels, and the camera samples set to 6 and 5. And I'll go to the, I'll switch off the progressive refinement and then do the refresh render and then see how much time it takes to complete this render. I'll update with you. So the total render has taken 17 minutes 41 seconds. So if you see the image, there's a lot of noise in this. This is for me, I could say this is very costly render when there are no materials in this particular scene, and the render size is not even full HD, and the render time is almost 17 minutes. If I put all the values put together, it can go up.